Good morning, friends, and welcome to episode 74 of Looking at Stamps. And today we are going to talk about stamps, but we're also going to talk about stamp placement. So I'm going to take you through a post-crossing processing, how I send out and make decisions regarding post-crossing postcards. So the first thing I do is I usually work in groups of four or five postcards. And the first thing that I will do is I will print out the addresses. I will use the smallest font possible. I will print out the postcard ID, and then I'll also print out the mailing label. And I usually do this per sheet. And then the next thing that I do is I cut them to size. Because I like using paper labels because it allows me to use the actual address as entered by the person receiving the postcard. And the third step is to read the profile and try to find something in my stock that I have that meets the requests of the person wanting postcards. And I'm sending a postcard to Germany and the person likes landscapes. So I thought that I would send this particular card. This is the Arches National Park in Utah. It's one of my favorite cards. And so this is the back side of the card. And then it comes time to lay out the card. Now, I have two areas marked here. The first is a half inch from the bottom. It's recommended that you not write or put anything 1/2 inch from the bottom of the card. So that the scanner can scan easily. And then, just from personal experience, I also have marked off 1/4 inch from the side. I also use 1/8 inch, depending upon what it is that I'm putting on there. And I try to put nothing on this edge here, because what tends to happen is the sorting machines catch here as it's being entered or exiting. And so sometimes, and you will see little scrapes of paper to where it has started to separate from the postcard, from the processing machine. So I try not to put anything there so that the label won't catch, so that a stamp won't catch and get torn off. And so this is my actual label that I'm going to use, and this will probably go down here in about this area for the address label. And please also keep in mind that the scanning machine will read the lowest address on your postcard or on your mail. So don't put a return address anywhere down here. I made the mistake of putting a address label here and then my return label here, and it got sent back to me. It got sent to me because it was reading the lowest address. So I will always put my address label up in the top right corner. So then comes the decision of stamps and stamp placement. Now I'm going to put this sideways so that I can work easier. Now I have a variety of different choices depending upon how I want to send a card to the recipient, the request of the recipient, how well I know the recipient, and if the recipient is a stamp collector. So if I wanted to, this is the National Parks stamp set. There is an Arches stamp that would match almost perfectly to the, let's see if I can get them both in the screen. How about we do it this way? Which would almost perfectly fit this particular postcard. Now, because this is going to Germany, I'm going to need more than one stamp. So I would need 2 Forever stamps and a 5-cent makeup stamp. If this was going to the United States and it was someone that appreciated stamps, or that I know would appreciate stamps, or that I know personally, I would probably use this stamp, and this is all that I would need, especially if they're in the United States. Since this is going to Germany and the person has not requested any particular idea of stamps or the appreciation of stamps, I will use some Forever stamps. Now, this is one of my favorites as well. This is the Wild and Scenic Rivers. So I will use one of those. I will likewise use one of the Oh Beautiful stamps. and that is this particular stamp series. And then what I will try to do is try to match color. So since I know there are a lot of blues and a lot of oranges, I'm going to look for those particular colors in deciding what stamps I'm going to use. So I could either use this orange one or this orange one. So I will probably use this particular stamp. I will probably use either this one or this one. I'll probably use this one because it's got the blues and oranges in it as well. Now, what I tend to do, now these are both the same size horizontally, even though they're the different sizes, same size vertically, even though they're different sizes horizontally. So what I will do is I will put the largest stamp first. So there is that particular stamp. And this stamp will go next. This is kind of hard to do this way, but you get the idea. Now those are a little crooked, but I could take this off if I really wanted to, since I haven't really put it down, but I have. Okay. So that's what I get for trying to do it this way. Now the question is, what third stamp do I use? So I've shown you a variety of different 5-cent stamps that I have available. This is the Davy Crockett stamp, and it's also a horizontal stamp. This is the C.M. Russell stamp. This is the John Muir stamp. But this is a vertical orientation, and I'll discuss that tomorrow. So I'm just going to use this particular Davy Crockett stamp. I'm licking it now. And then because this is a different size, I will center this on the stamp that is currently there. I know this is going to absolutely drive me crazy, and I'll have to put it in the mail without looking at it. So there we have $1.15. Okay. Now, the reason why this stamp placement is important is, let me show you some things. Back in the day, we used to try to get what was called a bullseye. And this is a card that I send to myself, and I highly recommend that you send cards to yourself so you can see how the postmarks work. So this is a series of 5 stamps because I wanted to see how many stamps I could put on there that would be covered by the postmark. Because what I don't want is I don't want them to marker or take a pen to cancel the postmarks, cancel the stamps, I should say. So what we know is that from the right edge to the ends of the cancellation is about 4 inches. The top of the postmark is about 1/4 inch. The bottom of the postmark, which is the cancellation here, is about 1 inch. So that's the area that you have to work with. But now, back in the day, we used to try to do what was called a bullseye. And a bullseye is when the date stamp, there's two parts of the cancellation. There's the date endorsement, and then there are the wavy cancellation lines. So we would try to get this centered on the stamp that we wanted to show the city and state of the stamp. Now this is a New York stamp, and it has New York, New York on it. So that's highly prized. Sometimes when we have large hand cancellations, we used to do a block of 4 stamps, and that is considered a bullseye. In the old days, you used to get these kind of stamps, cancellations, and these are just line cancellations. And then here's one that's prized. This is a New York stamp with a New York, New York cancellation. And so what we would do is we would measure 4 inches from the side, and that's where we would put our favored stamp so that we could get the best chance of being having it canceled on the stamp that we wanted. So that is all the time we have for today. Have a great day, and we'll talk about more stamp placement tomorrow. Bye-bye.